We're taking our questions about South Carolina's issues updating its child support enforcement computer system to the top. Project engineer Jimmy Early has only been on the job since 2015, but he's become the man who knows the most about what it will take to complete this project, which has already been delayed by decades and has cost millions in taxpayer dollars.
So since you've been on the job, what have been the challenges that you've seen?
There are a lot of challenges with any project of this scope and complexity, but we have a really good partner with Xerox, who's changed their name. They're now Conduent. But they've been a good partner, and they have a lot of child support experience. They implemented the system in Delaware that we're transferring to South Carolina. They've done this in a number of different states. So they come to us with a body of knowledge and an understanding that really helps our team and the state team as we sit down and look at how we need to design and develop the system.
How have parents and children been impacted by these delays, you know, that have left South Carolina as the last state in the country to implement this system?
Well, I certainly think there's opportunity for improvement, and we expect to see those benefits as we deliver the new system. I would say simply having one central statewide system will be a huge benefit in and of itself, both from the county perspective and the state perspective. We'll have a more holistic view of the data. Some of the delays that we are experiencing now in exchanging information between counties and the state will be eliminated once we're in a single system.
So we talked to Senator Katrina Sheely, and she says that she believes the spending, the money that has been spent on these delays, is wasteful and negligent. Do you agree?
Certainly, it's unfortunate. Again, I can't speak to the challenges and the obstacles that were encountered on the previous projects. Our focus is on making sure we deliver a system through this project. But certainly, again, that level of frustration and the money that's been spent on the project, the concerns about that, they're understandable. And we just need to make sure we don't have that conversation again during this project.
Can this process be sped up at all?
Well, we really looked at that. We looked at it hard. And anytime you look at something like this, you have to balance risk and reward. And the three-year timeline actually is very aggressive for a project of this scope and complexity, as we've talked about. And the three-year timeline that we have in place today to design, develop, and test the system, based on what I've seen, is very much in line with what timelines you've seen in other states. So we looked at it, but we didn't feel like, given the risk involved, it would be the wise thing to do, and that actually we would end up spending as much as we hope to save by trying to add more resources to the project or look at different approaches for developing the system. So we feel like we've got the right approach. We feel like we're taking the right path.
Is this system update going to fix every issue with child support enforcement?
This is a computer system that will help identify those parents who owe child support, who are late paying child support, and it will give users at both the county and the state level new tools to enforce those payments or try to compel those parents to pay. But at the end of the day, a computer system won't impact someone's willingness to pay or ability to pay. Those are decisions that parents have to make.
For now, though, all 46 counties in the state and the Department of Social Services use different computer systems, but the new one would change that. It's taken decades to do this, causing the Palmetto State to accrue more than $145 million in fines, on top of millions more in project cost. The expected completion date is September 30th, 2019.